So number 29, here is the equation they give us. They give us 2x sine y cosine y. And that's y prime is equal to 4x squared plus sine squared y. So, I have that sine y cosine y. That looks like a problem. And then I have sine squared y. And that looks like a problem. And so I'm trying to think what might be a good substitution to make. So, if you will think back to when you were learning integration by parts, or when you were learning U substitution. When you picture U, you always try to keep in mind what its derivative was going to look like. So when we think about which one of those functions to pick as our substitution, let's bear in mind what its derivative might look like. If you pick sine squared, what does its derivative look like?
2 sine y
cosine y. So would that be a reasonable substitution to make?
Yes.
Yeah. When we rewrite the equation, now how's it going to look?
X on that is x, b, or that is x. Yeah, that. Whatever's going on over there.
All right, x, b. Now, x.
X,
d, v, d, x. D, v, d, x, yes. Yeah. Okay. And what's on the right side? Okay. Where do we go from here? Subtract the V. Okay. Divide out that X. And now we recognize this as first order linear. So now we need our integrating factor. So this would really just be the same as 1 over x. Okay. Are we done with this page? Alright, so when we multiply through, we're going to get 1 over x dv dx minus 1 over x squared v. And the other side, we just get 4?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the derivative with respect to x of 1 over x times v. So this would really just be v over x. This is f right here. This is f, and this is f prime. So the derivative of x to the negative 1 is negative x to the negative 2.
Gotcha.
All right? And we said v was sine squared of y. I think I would probably stop right there on this one. You probably could get y by itself, but you'd end up taking the square root of both sides, which would give you a plus or minus on the right, and then you'd have to take the inverse. I think I would call this one solved. Now, I'm not going to work another one, but let's just talk real quickly about some of these. On number 16, if you let your v equal x plus y plus 1, then dv dx would just be 1. So let's see. That wouldn't let you solve for dy dx. Let me see what I did with that one. Let me pause this a minute. Y'all remind me to start this.